Principium is the beginning of our story. Not only is it our first full release, it is really the beginning of all the stories that Napierdalać will tell. Each track will get its own sort of spin-off album, as it were, and we'll fully explore each track through the medium of another album. Nuclear War kind of explores the anxiety of the constant threat that the world could just be destroyed any minute nowadays. And it's, we just have to live with that.
If you live in an area where a fallout warning has been given, stay in your fallout room until you are covered is safe to come out. When the immediate danger has passed, the silence will sound a steady note. The all-clear message will also be given on this wavelength. If you leave the fallout room to go to the lavatory or replenish food or water supplies, do not remain outside.
Good evening, Manchester. How the fuck are we doing? Better late than never.
Rights. It uses the old folklore of the myling to kind of commentate on what religion has done to essentially obliterate female sexual rights and really all sexual rights. It's so frustrating because there's this god above you that's dictating what you can and can't do with your own body. It just seems outrageous, and it is.
We'll be right back.
Masters of the East was actually about Ukraine, the East, referring to Eastern Europe. It really explores the rage of just being thrown into the midst of war, the abortive gulf, as it were, with no or very little outside help. But ultimately, it's a song about camaraderie, of coming together and working together to defeat and annihilate an enemy, whatever that may be. And in today's climate, which is full of war, it's more relevant than ever.
We'll be right back.
Sexy Addicted Vampires is a fun one. It was actually the first song ever written for Napierdalać, so it's kind of always had a special place in my heart. It tells a tale of a man and a woman, and the woman in this relationship becomes violently obsessed with sex to the point where she ends up almost killing her husband. In the end, she's knocked away for her madness, but like her legacy just continues to haunt the victim, and he's forever tied down by the chains that she's placed upon him.